So the individual is devoted to the community, yet the community is dependent on the individual's devotion. Now the community is devoted to the economy. How would this happen? So if you want a powerful person to make themselves abundant, full of their individualness, and abundant, full of what they have to offer, and then they're in that community, and those communities, families, are doing things, creating something. They may be creating houses, they may be working on a farm with a community of plants. The community is creating something. Then in the economy, or the marketplace, the different communities, families of creators come together to exchange what they've created, what they've understood, and to share what they've created, understood, experienced with other families, other groups, other communities. And this creates an economy. After the economy, so there we have the individual is devoted to the community, yet the community is dependent on the individual. The community is devoted to the economy. So the community should be trying to produce products, produce experiences, produce information, produce whatever that they are manifesting so that they can bring it into the economy and share it within the economy. The community is devoted to the economy. Now we have an economy. We have a whole bunch of communities sharing their goods, sharing their products, creating a surplus. What do we devote this surplus to? We devote this surplus to the next aspect of the society, which begins connecting more and more pieces, which would be the ecology or the ecosystem. So if you, you know, had your community of artists living in a city, and then they produced and manifested a bunch of art, they brought it to the larger spectrum of the society, into the economy, and they traded their art for some paper so that they could bring that paper to a merchant with his goods that were brought to him on a truck from some sort of third party collector of resources from people who live on a family and a farm. And they give their paper to this person to bring these foods back to their home. Maybe on the way, they also give some paper to a person so that they can have a new disc to listen to some cool meditation music. And what's happening with all this paper? Well, we understand, what's happening with our society is not important. What I'm talking about now is the utopia. All of this manifestation, all of this abundance that should be happening, because we are abundant creatures of light, we should be creating much more than we need, and we should be manifesting much more than we need, especially when involved in family communities and economies. And all of this paper should then be going back into the ecosystems. And they should be going into where there is lack of abundance in the ecosystem, obviously, so that the flow and the manifestation can happen with more ease. So yeah, we have all these families who are now doing all these things in the economy, creating this abundance that is fixing the lack of abundance in the ecosystem that would be basically brought to to parts of the ecosystem that need the assistance. By doing this, the ecosystem would be developing more abundance, and it would be releasing more third dimensional abundance energy into the cosmos. The cosmos would then synchronize the third dimension or our planet with more of this abundance energy that we are creating, and the cosmos would output a similar frequency into individual physical manifestations that can be known as people, plants, whatever, the self, the individuals.